everyone. I'm going to tell you today how to make two different kinds of origami cicada. One uses a pattern that you can download and it has the cicada already drawn on it. And the other one, you can use all sorts of different types of paper, whatever you happen to have. Now, I have a wide range of paper that I like to use. Sometimes I use a calendar. Sometimes I like to use brochures or maps. I also will sometimes use paper that's specifically made for origami. I've got some larger paper and then some itty little bitty pieces as well that are make quite cute little figures. And then finally, you can always, of course, use just plain white paper. Any type of paper you have, as long as you cut it into a square, you can make origami with it. So to get started, I want to show you the pattern that you can download. Now, this, as you can see, is for the 13-year cicada. And here in Indiana, we're actually getting the 17-year cicada. But I just think it's so cute, and it's close enough to the 17-year cicada that I think we can use it anyway. All right, so the first thing I'm going to do is cut out the square and put the instructions over here on the side of the page. I'm just folding mine in half so that it's a little bit easier to fit them right down in front of you to show you how to work with them. So I'm going to start out with the cutout, then I'm going to fold it in half to make a triangle. Now be careful that you line up the corners here as best you can, because we want to have that be a nice straight even triangle. So now I'm going to make a diamond, and I'm going to do that by taking those yellow corners and folding them up to meet with the top part where the eyes are, making sure that they're not visible when I'm done with my triangle. And once I'm done with that, I will take those same yellow corners, kind of look inside to gauge about where I want to have it be fit, and then fold them down so that the points of the corners face downward. And you want to try and get those as even as possible on both sides, but if it's not perfect, don't worry about it. Then I'm going to fold the head straight down, all the way down, and I'm going to take a little peek underneath, and then I will fold it so that it's facing up again. Then finally, I want to take the edges to make it look a little bit more cicada-like and fold them underneath so we get that nice classic cicada shape. Something still doesn't look quite right though. Ah, so I forgot to fold the nose under. So if you fold the nose down, you get a nice round cicada shape. And now you have got your first 13-year cicada. Next, we're going to move on to making a classic cicada pattern. And you can find the instructions to this on the link that's in the description below. I'm going to start out by using just a plain sheet of origami paper for the first version of this. You again take it and you fold it in half into a triangle, making sure that you flatten the edges and try and keep it as even as you possibly can. Then you take the bottom corners, fold them up so that the points line up with the top of your triangle, and make a diamond shape. Now, note here that the color side of the paper is on the outside. It doesn't really matter, but I like to have most of my cicada be brown. Now I'm just going to fold down those triangles once again. And again, I'm trying to keep it at a slight angle when I'm folding them down so that they peek out the sides at the bottom. But I'm also trying to make sure that both sides are even so that the cicada's wings are open the same amount on either side. So this is what it should look like at this point. Now I'm going to take the top layer of paper in the top part of the triangle and fold it down. Again, I'm not doing it all the way. I've got like a centimeter of paper up at the top between the center line and where I'm folding it. And now I'm going to take the other part of that top triangle, the other sheet, and I'm going to fold that down as well. Again, leaving about a centimeter maybe between the last fold and this new fold so that there's a little strip of the white exposed. Now I'm going to fold down the edges on the outside, maybe a little less, so that we get the nice rounded cicada shape, and that's what it'll look like on the back. Now I'm going to do the same thing on the other side, but before I totally flatten it down, I want to make sure that it's even. So I'm going to take a look at it here And yep, that looks pretty even to me. So I'm just carefully flattening that down. And well, it's not perfect, but it looks pretty good on the front. Now this isn't in the instructions, but I often like to kind of do a light fold in the center to help the cicada stand up the way I want it to. Great, so now you're done with your first version of a classic origami cicada. So now I'm going to show you how to do it with a few other pieces of paper. Now you can also just use a plain white sheet of paper if that's what you have. And I usually like to fold these into a sort of triangle shape. So just fold one edge right to the other side, because that gives me a good guide at the bottom for how to cut it to make myself a nice, nearly perfect little square. And the bonus of this time is that we already needed to fold and have to make a triangle anyway. So I'm just going to fold it like I did the last time with the other sheet of paper. Ta-da! And while I'm doing that, I will give you another cicada fact. Did you know that cicadas actually have little straws instead of teeth? So what the cicada does is instead of biting its food, it sticks a little straw into the tree, drinks up the liquid in the tree, and that's how it eats for its entire life. So they can't actually bite, they can only drink. So now we've got this cicada almost all wrapped up, but we're not done yet. So since we have a plain white cicada, we can decorate it with markers all we want. I'm also going to pull out this cicadas and their lookalike sheet. I got this off of the Purdue Cicada website. You can download it there too and use it as a reference for the 17-year cicada we'll be making. I'm going to use this sort of golden brown initially to draw in the wings. So you'll notice there are these lines on the wings. Those are the wing veins. And those are the only parts of the cicada's wings that actually have color in the 17-year cicada. The rest of the wings are sort of transparent, and you can see the rest of the cicada body through them. Now I'm giving them these kind of curved arches. I'm not being super precise here. You can go into as much or as little detail as you want. But I'm just trying to capture that swooping, almost lacy effect that cicada wings have. Now, the female cicadas will actually use their wings to make a kind of clicking noise. That is how they reply to male cicada songs. Now, if you snap your finger, it actually sounds a lot like the clicking of the female cicada's wings, and you can trick male cicadas into hopping right up onto your shoulder if you click your fingers near your shoulder. They'll think that a female cicada is there, and they will hop right over. It's pretty fun. You can have a nice little cicada friend for at least the few minutes while it takes them to figure out there's no female cicada there. Next, I'm going to do the eyes. It's not coming super clearly through in the video just because my printer was running out of red ink, but 17-year cicadas have these dramatic bright red eyes, and I'm going to draw them here as kind of little googly eyes just because I think they look kind of more friendly that way. It's not as scientifically accurate, but I think it makes them look kind of cute. Then finally, I'm going to take my dark brown marker and kind of shade in the rest of the cicada. I'm doing kind of a quick job here just because I want to show you some general ideas, but you can color in as much as you want, as precisely as you want. I'm sort of trying to give it the general shape of how the cicada's body is actually shaped. So it's got a little bit of a dome on top, but you can do it however you want. With the tiny paper, it's the same idea. You're doing the same folds. You just need to be a little bit more careful because if you make a mistake with these smaller pieces of paper, it tends to show up more. So I also wanted to throw out there that you can make origami out of calendars. I actually had this perfect Indiana calendar. Thought, you know, since we're based in Indiana, I'll use the Indiana calendar. And it was already a square, so I didn't have to worry about, you know, cutting it up to make the rectangle into a square. I picked the calendar image for the month of May because that's when cicadas are supposed to come out here in Indiana. The only downside is it's a little bit green, which is more like the dog day cicadas than the 17-year cicadas we're expecting to emerge soon here. But I still think it looks pretty, and I like the symbolism of it. All right, and with that, you have two different patterns for making cicadas, and four different types of paper that you can use. If you think of anything else, again, please do share those with us on social media. We would love to see what you come up with. And I hope you all get a chance to enjoy the cicadas. I know I will. All right, so I kind of wanted to see what it would look like with the more accurate red eyes. Oh dear. Nope, the brown is not helping. Adding the brown is not helping. I think we have our first Mothman cicada here. So I would recommend going with the less accurate sort of googly eyes than necessarily the more accurate red eyes on these cicadas, straight up red eyes, unless you want a little bit of an intimidating kind of cryptid cicada situation.